It's been always been my opinion that the true history of American Indians have never been told. One reason I believe is it's dynamic, it changes. Our people have always been adaptive to change, and through this process it's very difficult to capture the true history of our people.
Imagine the deep cool of a primal forest. We were there. Imagine the wild rapids of a spring flood. We were there. Imagine a flock of a million passenger pigeons so large that it blackened the sky. We were there. Know this about the land. It was not India, and it was definitely not empty. We welcome the great floods of the Mississippi River to restore and deepen our agricultural lands each summer. And with the wealth that nature provided, we built large cities like Cahokia near modern-day St. Louis, a planned city of 10,000 built around 100 ceremonial and burial mounds.
All the southeastern tribes, our old customs were to bury our people in mounds, great mounds, and to also bury things with them. We all go back to where we started. And our tradition tells us that we spend our life starting on Mother Earth. We're born on Mother Earth. We pass on and then our bones are reinterred in Mother Earth. And so this cycle of life is really like the cycle of the human spirit.
Believe that the earth is our mother, and in order to recognize that, certain people built mounds, and they do this to recognize the mother. During pregnancy, you see the mother change. So in recognizing what we call Teek Inhashi, the women's month, there were times when they built mounds, and they were small mounds, and it was more of a recognition of the female rather than a burial or a ceremonial.
We tattooed our bodies and etched our art into copper and seashell ornaments. We celebrated the relationship of our clans to native animals in beautifully carved stone. We played a spectacular game of stickball on huge fields near our ceremonial grounds, the first American baseball. On the eve of European exploration, we lived in stable villages, in cane and plaster or log homes. We had peace communities,